What's up, guys? How you doing? Hi there, you okay? You ready to see some baby tapirs? Have a little look-see, see what we need to do to start off with. Exactly where we left off yesterday. March at the minute, I think they were due in June, so it's only 3 in-game months and the babies will be born. Oh yeah, the empty exhibit, we'll have to get something else in there, won't we? He's just led in his own poop. And I think, in case you didn't guess from the title, I'm going to do a Dwarf Caiman exhibit here. We're probably going to have similar like looking in areas along here, and then a land section here. And then we'll have like a swampy water part here that you can see into from the path. But they're both South American, and Caimans don't need much land, so it's an easy one to slot in there. And then I'm going to redo a staff area as well, just because we're going to need like a keeper hut over here and stuff like that. Lots of babies running around in this exhibit now. Oh, we filled the empty exhibit, didn't we? We put some frogs in. Tickets are underpriced. Oh, not 60. There's the mechanic, he's not far away. We've got all the tapir facts now as well, so we can have a little look at those soon. We won't do them straight away. We are going to have to get rid of some ostriches though, because they'll start fighting. Just those two, they both gotta go. So I think I'll start off. We just need to put some heat in the tapir one. That's something we forgot to do yesterday. I'll just pop one outside just so I can get the temperature right and then duplicate it. -16 to -40, so we'll do like 23 degrees or something like that. Get them nice and tucked in. Then we can get rid of that one. Oh, there we go. It happened. June came faster than I thought. We have one baby tapir. Atsy is its name. And it's a little girl. I think we just got the one. Yeah, just the one. So we've got the heat in there. We can start on the Cayman ones, I think. I get that big rock that we had under there just for doing the outlines again. Need to turn that off as well. Gonna get annoying doing this part. And once we've got this one done, we'll neaten everything up in here for the guests and put down like information stuff and things like that. More ostrich babies as well. And extend this path a little bit. Right. very annoying time for it to go to night time just as we start there. Another ostrich is pregnant. They're just breeding like wildfire now. See what these are. Oh, he's starting to get stressed. I think that just happens occasionally with the guests being able to look in. I can't really stop it yet. It shouldn't happen with here because of how we built it with all the foliage and everything. And all the future exhibits are going to be more like this, so. We can do the tapir facts as well now that the baby's been born. Have a little look. So tapir is the largest land mammal in Central America. The closest evolutionary relative of the tapir is the rhino. A group of tapirs is known as a candle. Tapirs are important seed dispersers in their environment due to their varied diet and wide-ranging foraging behavior. And tapirs are excellent swimmers and spend large parts of their day in water. When swimming, they can use their prehensile snout as a snorkel. We already knew that because how much time they're spending in the water that we put there. That's been fixed. They're mating as well. We're going to have a lot of babies running around this exhibit. Some more being born up there, for God's sake. The sooner we get this one done and we can change that into something else, the better. Baby tapirs are calves. I think I'll have to build some kind of zookeeper entrance into the back as well. If we can undo that, because we might be able to get a big one like that might be quite nice. I'm sure there's a way to do curved barriers. It's only certain pieces. Again, this part will probably turn into glass and raise up again, so it's similar to the tapir one. And then this can all be a nice little inside bit for the guests as well. We don't really need this to be too deep. I wonder how we can get it. Do we need to sort of raise over here? I know this sort of looks ugly at the minute, just bear with me. Yeah, something like that is what we want, where it's like against the water. Like against the waters, against the glass, I think that looks super cool. And then we'll just have to bulk out this area a little bit. same piece, isn't it? I want one of the big ones. We are probably going to have something there. That could be fine though, and we can build the little house into this part. It looks okay, I think. I would like to like smooth that out a little bit if we can. Can't really be smoothed anymore, I don't think. There's some of these nice rocks in there, that should be okay. Without the only reason I've put them there is just because I'm worried about them being able to get in the water, because that's quite a steep drop without it. I think I just sort of have to have them there. I will blend it in though, so it won't look so sudden, if you know what I mean. I know, it's just with the way that the game works with the pathing. If it's too steep, they just won't do it because it'll like register as a steep drop, if you know what I mean. It will look good when I've done, don't worry. We'll fix all the old, because it does look a little bit crappy there. I'll make it a little bit smaller for now. Is there a thinner version of that? Oops. How high is this fence? 2 meters. The Just using that as a measuring stick to see whether they'd be able to get over it or not. I might add a little bit onto these. Yeah, I think maybe here is going to be the best spot to have the entrance for the keeper. I hope this is big enough for them. I'm sure it will be. They're only small, aren't they? Ah. Right. Maybe if we have a little... We made that a bit smaller. There we go. That's a little better. We don't want that, we want something a little bit longer. There we go, that should be fine, you should be able to get up there. The baby's about to grow up. That means we're going to have to release them now. Yeah, you can only have one of each. So we'll have to release him. Get a ton of grass under here. I only speak English, sorry dude. Welcome to the stream though. want it to look nice and swampy in here. Oops, move that in a little bit. I'm not sure if they'll use this, but it'd be pretty cool if they do. Why the poles wood now? I think that's looking pretty decent so far, isn't it? You'll be able to see pretty much everything from in here as well. Even get like a little box feeder under there, you might like it. Have access to water there, and then we'll get a nice little like food thing. I'm guessing they probably just want the same temperature as the tapirs as well, just double check. I think they're from the same area, so yeah, we can do. So we'll just duplicate some of their ones. And pop them around here. We'll maybe do one inside their thing. And then one down here, which we will put maybe the other side of there. Does that cover what we want it to? That's annoying, even when you duplicate them, it doesn't change the temperature. There we go, that'll be fine anyway. Anything else we need to think about before we get them? I know we're going to need enrichment, but I'm not sure what they'll play with yet, so... This is just two again, so we only need to fit two in. Can live for 50 years, which is pretty cool. So we're going to have them for a while. Oh, there we go, we've got some unlocked already. We'll get like a sprinkler in, ice ball. We've not got any of the food ones yet. But we can do them too easily. Sprinkler is one of my favourite ones, so I'll always put that in if I get the option to. Sprinkler. Maybe have the sprinkler on here because it might encourage him to go. Oh, I think maybe it has to be on terrain. He'll definitely be able to get on that one. We do need to get some electric done over here though, so. We put this path down, stretch this down here because this is where it's going anyway. Then we'll do like a staff path that goes along here. We'll be able to make it like a nice little decorative area there. That's fine, and then we can get like a generator and everything here. Let's have a look at that tapir. She's about to grow up. She's about to grow up. The rubber duck. I can put the rubber duck in. Say goodbye to the baby. It is a very cute baby, isn't it? Are they mating again? Or are they just fighting? Oh no, one of the tapirs has a disease. That's not good. And we're not gonna know what disease it is either. Straight away. Alright, there we go. We're gonna have to start researching it quickly. I'm going to hire another vet because we are making a lot of money now. I think we can afford it. Last month. Yeah, we had 12,000 expensive, 25,000 income. So I think we're probably safe there. How much are these making? It is decent money, I suppose. This is about to open as well with the Caimans. That's making tons. Yeah, we're gonna get a second vet. We can't train him straight away. We're gonna have to get them researching straight away though. Because we do not want the tapirs to die. That's the tapir being taken to the quarantine. I don't know how it fits in that box, but... I swear this one should have grown up by now. It's saying that it's an adult, but it's clearly not. There we go. But he's gonna have to get, they're gonna have to get released now, so. Oh, we get barely anything for releasing him. Such good stats as well. Not that good, I suppose. Are they cured? How did that happen? We'll still research it in case it crops up again. What were we just about to do? The rubber duck, weren't we? We wanted a rubber duck. Should we see if it can float? Turn off a line to surface for a start. I don't know if that's going to work, but... I feel like we should wait to get the Caimans now. If it was me, I'd hate to come in on a day like this. Then again, they're aquatic, aren't they? That'll rotate. No! That was a close one. We're gonna have to get rid of some of these. We don't want that happening. Let's see what we've got. So the ostriches are fine, we just got a couple of babies. Who are the original ones? They're not original. Neither's he. Bio is. I don't know the current... I don't know the mum is. Bio. So it's just those two. All the rest of you can go. Probably a couple other animals we can get rid of, just this frog, I think. And then we're all fine there. We're going to keep, I think, this... We're going to keep this male ostrich and then trade the rest out and get some new breeding females in, because Zacomo's 30 years old now, so he must not have much longer left. That frog can get sold. Looking good there, so let's look for the animals that we want. We want Caiman. We can get young ones. They're the youngest. We'll go for Barbara. And Daniel, which ironically is my name. Keep the girls. Yeah, that does make more sense. Both of them quarantined. Ready. Uh-oh, we've had a lot of frogs. And now they're unhappy because there's too many of them in there. Only two. No need to complain about that. Probably an extra iguana. We're all good there. There we go, already just from having one in that is potentially going to save one, because I think it reduces the chance of it by like 75%. Yeah, discovery time as well, and time it takes them to die from it, so we have more time to cure them if it does come again. Oh, we've done that. Now we just wait for them... Caimans to finish quarantine and we can get them in. And then we'll build more staff facilities around here that are just going to look after these animals. I wish I'd have pre-thought where the entrances were going, because I think I would have preferred to put the tapir entrance around here as well, so they're close to each other. Not too far for them to walk, though. My report. My education's going up slowly. Oh yeah, we should probably carry on with this. put one of these, that's really annoying me. Just gonna pause it just because I spotted that they were ready there, but I'm not, so gonna get a tiny bit more up here. Patch up any gaps. That looks alright to me now. We get them in. Where are they? There we go. We'll see whether I've done a decent job and see if they're happy straight away or how much we need to change. I might at some point do a little bit more of this kind of stuff as well with the vines on the Caiman side. It kind of looks good how it is though, doesn't it? What do you think? Should we add the vines or not? Yeah, keep put the vines on. That is one tiny gator. Just check all its it can get up there. Get in its bed. And get to all its toys as well. The only sad part is it can't walk along the log, which I'm a bit unhappy about. Maybe if I can move it. Because I really want him to be able to walk along this. Something like that. Is that going to fix it for you? You can go over it, that'll do. They're happy with the terrain and everything. They don't actually need deep water, these guys. That doesn't really matter. I got everything surprisingly perfect right from the start. Even got 100% enrichment. I'm happy with that. And watch them a little bit, I think. Just gonna leave that on for a little bit and I'm just gonna nip to the toilet. I'll be back in a minute. There we go, do like that. I'll be right back. Thanks for waiting. Kind of cool, aren't they? I think I'm going to do the same as well and get a second mechanic just so one of them's always on research and one of them can look after the fences and stuff like that. Oh, there we go. We're going to need another janitor as well. Maybe we'll just upgrade this one. Yeah, just doing it now. Gonna say they're not looking at him for free. That's pretty good so far. And now I'm gonna look to get some. I'm gonna get all the information stuff done for these two guys down here. And then roof this off. So it's all enclosed. Probably put a nice sign outside. And then do the staff area because we need a second like energy supply thing over here as well. I need to sort out the spare animals again first though, because probably a bunch. Yeah, so we'll... Bear with me. We'll pause it and we'll get rid of the two males for the ostriches. They can get released. Oh, Zacomo can't be released. Too old, I think. We'll trade him out. And then we'll get them puff adders gone again. What's a disease risk? Oh, damn it. I didn't think about that. We need to get a water cleaning pump. That's probably where they got the diseases from. Right, we'll do that first then before we do the guest stuff, because that's obviously important. We'll get a little wind turbines just because you eco-friendly, isn't it? Solar panels are a little too small. But that covers everything there, so... on the heat map. Yeah, so that's the entirety of those two exhibits covered now. Just a tiny bit there, but there's nothing there that needs to be powered. There we go, that'll fix the water problem. Yeah, so that's sorted out now. I think. Just want to check what ostriches were just born. That's just to mark them so we know which ones we need to. In fact, we can keep her, but he can't stay. That's not much for Zacomo, is it? Probably splash out on a guy who's got decent genes. This one. Only two and a half. Was, I think they live up to like 40, so we're going to have him for quite a while. And we can release him, because we've adopted him rather than buying him. Quick look at the hogs. You can go once you're grown up. We'll do the same with the hogs, so as soon as they've all grown up, we're going to sell the alpha male and get a new one. There we go, that disease isn't going to sneak up on us again. Water still looks gross, doesn't it? This would be good as well, because any exhibits we do along here, we might make this into a little South America area. And we'll have, like, the zoo stuff central, like the keeper station and stuff like that, so that they can get easy access to all of them really quickly. I and we'll have someone assigned to the whole area. I think that'd be quite cool. Which one's more endangered out of these two? Because that's what we'll use for the main sign, just for like the main draw or whatever. So they're not endangered at all, but the tapirs are. Only 5,500 in the wild, that's mad. Trophy hunting, amulets and medicine. I'm just looking at the things that are a threat to them. Deforestation. Hunting. I think they come under signs. Stop. There's too many rocks under there. What was this one? Deforestation. Fortune, was it? Yeah. Double check I got them ones right for the other one. And then I want to make a nice little like sign for all the animals. Maybe we can make it out of this sort of stuff. Maybe we'll delete that one and then copy that just to make sure it's even. Hopefully that's the right size. I don't know which way is the right way around for that. Let's just start again. I just need to turn it on just to make sure it's right. There we go, that was pretty good. I'll just save that as well. God's sake. Information. And then we can delete that. Should be in here now. There we go, that looks pretty good, I think. Sort of similar to what you see in zoos. Put another one over here as well. I like that. And then this is a Caimans, isn't it? What do you think? Do you like the signs? This is like a little walkthrough so far. There's going to be a roof and everything, obviously, but... At the minute, it doesn't show much on the Cayman ones, but as you get more research from the vets, it adds more information on, like that. Eventually it has everything on there. I think one of the tapirs is pregnant again as well. Maybe not. I'm sure I saw that they were pregnant. Maybe not. That's the stress again, but again, there's literally nothing I can do about it now that this is built. Again, though, I'm not too worried about it just because this is going to go eventually, so... I'm really happy with this so far. It's leaps and bounds better than that first one that we did. Oh yeah, I forgot that we got another ostrich. I was like, what's past quarantine? I think that one's redundant just because that one's so close. Just move it, just to keep it. In fact, I'll probably move it to this side. Oh, there's not so many everywhere. Maybe one more here, just in case. There's zigzags all the way through there. What are people's thoughts on it so far? So many insults. The view of the common warthog from here is quite good. You can really tell they put a medium amount of thought into the planning. Yeah, everyone's just everyone. The only thing people are unhappy about at the minute is the size of the zoo, but obviously, they've just got to wait. I wonder what we can do for, like, getting this built up over here. Maybe a rock roof would look best. I reckon if we get these ones. Nope. These ones. Just build the roof out of that. And then we can fix top to make it look a bit more uneven afterwards. I think later on you can unlock, like, soil-looking stuff as well. It could be really good to get, like, this whole roof as, like, a planter. Make sure the sides look right, and then we'll mix it all up on top. Push that out a little bit. I think once we've got that, maybe we should get shops. I'm going to start one guy going on the South America theme, just because I figure if we're doing a South America area, we might as well just get started on that straight away. Oh, they've got their fish. Caiman's pregnant, and the tapirs are about to mate. Oh, sugar, of course. We're going to dump some extra facilities down here for now, just so they can use them. But obviously, we're going to tidy everything up. So don't worry about it looking ugly for now. Get a workshop in so he's available to use that straight away. I think maybe a large research center. Did we get a large one? I'm sure we did. There we are, large research center. And we'll get the keeper hut in here as well. I don't think there is a large keeper hut. Oh, there it is. Maybe offset that a little bit. Yeah, I like that as a building on its own, and then maybe that as a building on its own. Caimans about to give birth as well. Wait to see some babies. That fish looks stinky. You ready to see some baby caimans? Oh, there we go, he's walking on the log as well. They're basically the same size. I don't think that's quite correct. We got three of them. Just three, I think. That's still a lot, though, isn't it? They're still happy with the space they have and everything. Cool. What have we got in here now? We've got all girls and the one boy, so once they've grown up, we'll probably ship Daniel out. Not me, the Caiman. We'll ship him out and get a new one in, and then they'll be able to breed with all four of them then. It's looking good though, I think, around here. Let's have a look at what the guests can see. This is the tapir exhibit, which... Don't look. There's one there. We got a nice signs. Caimans. Oh, the baby does look really small from here, to be fair. See some of them swimming around as well. There's one just there. And there. And then we should be able to see the other one. Probably swimming. Maybe not. I wonder where the other one's gone. Probably hiding around here. There we go. I think that needs fixing though now. Yeah, we can. We can only have two caiman. It doesn't count juveniles though. Oh yeah, you're talking about the females, aren't you? Yeah, you might not be able to have multiple breeding ones. Let me double check. It's up here, isn't it? Yeah, only one male, one female. Well, we might as well keep Daniel then. We'll release all of the young ones into the wild once they... He's going to live for 50 years anyway, so... I think I'm going to try and turn up here into like a long planter and fill it with like South American jungle plants. Have I got anything I can do that with now? Even like a brown rock that I could like flag it as. Nothing there. Oh, there we go, mulch. Perfect. Yeah, just a huge chunk of it. That's probably the biggest, isn't it? Like a square instead. That's probably going to be better, isn't it? That looks fine, and then we'll put tons of the plants that we have down here over the bit that the guests walk on. Give it a nice finish, I think. And then I still want to make like a cool sign for the tapirs over the arch, because obviously with them being the most endangered, they're like the biggest draw. Looking good though, I like it. Those ostriches getting stressed again. I think once we've done this South American bit, we're going to have to get rid of them. What other ones are there from South America that we can have? Should we have a quick look? We'll get rid of that and then... You're not filtered by area. That's a little annoying. To see how much more we have to fit in there. We can make like exhibit areas as well with the South American exhibit animals like the centipede and stuff like that. We got the tapir done. Boa constrictor, exhibit one again. Exhibit. Okay, we gotta have a capuchin one somewhere. Got that. We'll probably have the Galapagos turtles, tortoises in there. Pretty much. Yeah, it counts as South America. That's fine. giant anteaters. That'll be a fun one to do. Otters. Those are monkeys, anteaters, otters, tortoises. If there's any more. Jaguars. Llamas. I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. So we've got six more, like, proper exhibits to do. And then a bunch of exhibit ones to fit in, but that'll be super easy because we can just put them on some of the inside bits like this. Like, I could have easily put some exhibits, say, there on that corner or there in the gap between the two. Six is perfect, though, because we got two there, so we can have two there, and two there. And then we'll have the keepers and a vets right in the middle for that section, and it'll be done. So that's going to be pretty easy, I think. We'll get all these plants up anyway. Right, let's pop some plants up. So we need South American jungle plant. We'll probably pop a few trees up there as well. That'll look quite nice, I think. I know you won't be able to see all of it from down there, but as long as there's little spots, it'll matter. Probably worth going a little smaller for that. That probably is a little bit too big of a tree. Probably get away with something like that. And we get the tiny tamarind tree as well. That'll look good. Yeah, that looks very jungly, doesn't it? What do you think? Need to add anything, or do you reckon that's fine? So if you've only just joined in, we've obviously got the tapirs living under here. There was a baby, but he's gone now. Cleanliness risk again. Oh, I just need a little bit of a wipe down. You liking it, yeah? And then we've got little caimans in here. There's one of the babies. So tough to see. Oh, I forgot to move the heater when I moved that. Here we go. But they're loving the rain when they're normally from the rainforest. Tell you what as well, I'm going to pop another one of the... Oh! You're in luck if you have just joined and you saw the title because we're about to see another baby tapir. Little stripey boy. Don't know where this baby is. Could be appearing any minute if it stood up. Where are you? There we go, one little stripey boy. Immediately got lost in the brush. There's a floating plant. There you go. If you did just join from the title and you wanted to see a baby tapir, there you go. all those warthog have just matured as well, so we'll just... Oh, the Caiman can play with the duck as well. Let me just pause it. We were wondering. It looks like they've been playing with it, so there we go. Let me just sort out the warthogs. We're just doing that just to mark the ones that we need to get rid of, essentially. When's this one born? We can keep that one. I think all the rest are... Yeah, all the rest are Cassias, so we've got to get rid of them ones. Otherwise, they'll be interbred. Who's this one? Yeah, that one's got to go as well. And then warthogs, we'll just get rid of these two. And then we'll get in a new male. I think there was an extra frog then as well. Here we go, so that's all tidied up. Whew. I'm quite proud of this. I'll make the entrance of this one a little bit better as well, similar to the other side as well. I think that was much better. I wonder if you can actually see him under there. Not really, it's kind of cool that the water's up against the glass though. And I think the guests can put down their umbrellas when they go in here as well. Yeah, so they all put it down. I wonder if the thought's changed yet. No, they're still being so insulting. The view of the Bard's Tapir from here is quite good. You can really tell they put a medium amount of thought into the planning. Put a lot of thought into the planning, thank you very much. What was I doing? An info thing. We'll pop another one of those down here. I might actually put a stood up one here. Put it like there. I kind of want to get one of the educators started now as well. Where's the educating spot? The animal talk point. We could put that like there, and we can have probably the tapir, because again, they're the endangered ones, so. We'll have it in August, so every August it'll do a talk about tapirs. And we're going to have to hire an educator as well. There we go. I need to unpause it a second. We'll put another one down for these Caiman as well. I don't want them just doing one job, so... Do the talk right next to the donation box. Food throw. What the hell? Food throw path is blocked. I didn't realise they can do feed-ins. That's pretty cool. I can't on this because obviously it's all encased with glass, so... That's good to know for in future that I might have a little section where we can go and do it properly. Be cool for like lions and tigers and stuff, won't it? That's a lot of people going to listen to us straight away. She doesn't start for like 11 days and they're already waiting to hear her talk. But wait and see this, just because I've never seen what this looks like before. Jesus, that's a lot of people. I don't think tapirs do that. There's so many people. Just the same thing on a loop, isn't it? That's pretty cool. I like that. And then she obviously got to start. A Caiman one around there. I wish there was a way I could do a feed-in for that one. That'd be really cool. I could maybe do a little path that goes along here at the top and see if they can throw it in, but I'm just not sure whether they'll be able to. I won't change anything because I don't want to mess it up, but I'm going to keep that in mind for future ones. We'll start researching some shops now to make some extra money. But we've still got that South America theme going. We're going to be focusing on that region for now, so we don't need any of the other themes just yet. Maybe the aquatic one I'll do after that, but just going to wait for it to be daytime, and then I'm going to get a little sign up here. I wonder if there's a tapir outline. No. Maybe you need the South America research for that. Seeing what we can make out of the pieces that we do have. The branches. That could be cool. There's like... No, undo that. This. No, we'll start with the trunk, that's fine. Is there a big branch? Not really what I want. I could get that log we had earlier, actually, couldn't I? We just like rotate it slightly this way. And then on a very, very slight angle. We might be able to get it like resting on there. Less of an angle, I think. And then just something like this, just so it looks like it is, like, held on. We rotate that a little bit. And if we go right back up, go through these notifications a second. Animals thirsty, what the hell are my keepers doing? What did we unlock with that? 323 South Americans. So we've got all the South American scenery now, the rest is just blueprints. Don't feed these iguanas, Jesus. One's on the way already. We're gonna have to get bins and stuff around here as well, I just realised. Getting sidetracked. Does that include new plants, I wonder? I don't know if this is new or just stuff that I didn't have picked earlier. Oh sure, we'll have more scenery though, we'll have a quick look at that. That's definitely new. Can't just be rope and a fence, surely. There's like 300 pieces. Ah, there we go. That's pretty cool. That'll be good for when we do the Jaguars. I think we'll make a really big deal out of the Jaguar exhibit as well, because that's normally like one of the main attractions of a zoo, isn't it? I like that. I'm going to stick with it. Is there a tapir on here yet? No, I just want a tapir. A lot of that's it. Does everything have the South American in the name? Can we just search by that? What would it be? That's one way just to see it all, isn't it? Bamboo, that's pretty cool. Bamboo walls as well. And we got green bamboo as well. Thatch. I think it'll be good as well. Eventually, I'll be able to move these into, like I said, we'll have an area with them in. And we can properly theme the exhibits and stuff like that. That's quite cool, because you can have that, like, trimming those signs that I've made. Oh, surely there's a tapir here. There we go. The Caiman's about to have babies again. The line to surf it. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. I was hoping to be Caiman as well. That would have been cool. We might leave that as decoration up there, but I've got a pretty cool idea for the sign. Little capuchins. Fake vines. I don't know why you would want fake vines when there's real vines, but...
No problem.
This is awesome, there's so much stuff. Probably benches as well, I'm assuming. Yeah, and bins. I'll probably keep it neutral on the main path, but then... I suppose it doesn't really matter, does it? We did need some bins, so... A lot of little caimans swimming around now. Don't know how they're all fitting in there. How many's in there now? One, two, three, four. Can't even see because there's that many. Oh, bear with me. To go out. No, the rest have grown up yet, I don't think. One's worthy, it was Barbara, wasn't it? There's one, two, three, six babies in there now. Can't trade Hadia, why not? Oh, already in the trade center. That's annoying. I'll just slide that along a little bit though. Cool though, we'll get like get some benches and stuff. Doesn't really make sense for it to be any around there actually. Maybe there I'll put some. That's nice, won't we do a big eating area, which is coming soon. How do you know, like, where crime is happening? We're making a lot of money now. What the hell is going on there? Just moved it. I will put it. So many babies and stuff now. It's so hard to keep track of. Right, so you. All need to go. And you. We're getting a decent amount of conservation points now as well, so we can start looking at a little bit rarer animals. We still won't be able to get like the crazy ones like the gorillas and stuff, but definitely all the ones for South America, which is obviously what we're concentrating on now. Fine, we can do that, and then we can sell all these. We should have quite a lot in here now. Nearly 5 grand. I think before I get him to carry on that, I'm going to get into the aquatic one as well, because that's something I might want. Because we do have all the stuff unlocked, it's just blueprints now, so. Stop having babies. The frog just have them as well. God damn. And the ostrich is about to as well. Oh, it's too much to keep track of. Ominous. We're gonna have to set up proper work areas soon. I wish you could set levels of what you want in the exhibits and then it'll auto sell all the rest. Because it's so annoying having to just constantly sell them all the time. I just saw the baby run in there then. Very cute. Their whole thing's gonna be fine, I think. Jesus, that's like 30 degrees. What's the temperature of the rest of them in here? 10. Tapir's gonna go away again. That's very close to being called Tupac, I appreciate that. We got a bunch more babies over the ostrich one. Yeah. Baby. 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 How long do the caimans live as well? It's probably a good thing to see. So I know when I need to be replacing one of them. It says adult, I'm just going to release him now. I thought we'd get more for the tapirs with him being endangered. It's a bit annoying that. It's slowly going up though, so we're good. Caimans, that's what we're looking at. Oh, so they live up to 50 years. That's... We're going to get a lot of babies out of them. 24 for the tapirs. How old are they now? So we're probably... The next baby they have, we're probably going to keep and then replace whatever gender we don't get. There's so many Caimans in here. I think if I deepen the water a little bit as well, they'll start to swim down. But I don't really want to mess with it. I'll think about it on the next one. We've got an aquatic one. I think there's otters coming up soon, so that'll be fun. I swear I already called a guy to this once. I need a staff room here anyway. I might actually try and get the staff room in there, that would be quite cool. Nah, it's not gonna have that, there's nowhere near enough room. Bit that way. No, it was worth a shot. Right, I'm gonna redo this because I don't like how it looks. Obviously, because I'm me. Right, I'm gonna have to get rid of this. I'm gonna pause it. They need to stay there, so. so ugly. That's not so bad. We'll have it like that. I do want it of its own vet section as well, so we're going to have to do another quarantine. Because if there's one of them sick, I don't want them to have to run. Like, if the furthest one's over here, I don't want them to run in, like, all the way back there. It's just not going to work. Will I be able to get a staff room in here now? Yes. What we want. Oh, that's very close to fitting. It's just a vet surgery we're going to need, not a quarantine. I'm going to get off that and then I'll place it myself. That's probably as close as we can go there. And then as close as we can forward. I'm just going to move these just to kind of deselect that. Yeah, split from group. I'm just going to move it. Don't want it on a grid. There we go. And then when we do the building here, we'll be able to like put a little... I know it doesn't make sense because it's a wind generator, but... In fact, I'm going to replace it with a regular generator. Like, literally just so it does make sense. So what have we got? Vet, staff room, we're going to need a keeper, we'll get a large one of those. And then we'll get a large research centre, this can be the main one, and then any others we get after this can just be... small ones. Add a workshop as well, just so the mechanic has somewhere he can go if he doesn't have any mechanicking to do. Oh, a lot of them were pre-made, that would actually look quite good as well. Should I put a quarantine here? really small one. There, that'll do for staff facilities around here, that's plenty. I think we'll make this all like South American rather than just generic. It fits the area a bit. I suppose the guests will be able to see the roofs over the top anyway, so that's my excuse for doing it. That's quite good for the edges, I like that. That'd be good as well for over in front of windows. Right, we'll start just with construction because we're going to just get a basic shape first of all. Probably mixture of temple bricks. Like red ones and regular ones, we'll probably go for a mix. Can I just edit this? Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I'm going to say I'm sure there's windows at the back of these. I'm going to literally start just by putting a shell on them all. I just want to see what it looks like. I think this one's gonna definitely need to be two stories, so I'm just gonna do that now. I'll do like one and a half. Because I don't want any of these to be really that big. On this one as well, I'll add one. Try and make them all different heights to break everything up a little bit. I'll edit that separately, otherwise it'll annoy me later on. I think we'll do one raise. We'll do them same height just because it's technically the same building. No windows on this one. We'll put some fake ones on later. Oh, that doesn't look right. That can stay low down. Yeah, this will look good, I think. or window trims. In fact, see if this fits how I wanted it. Oh, we might have to do a custom one. Well, we'll definitely have to do a custom one. It's literally not a window. Because we can do something like that, I guess. There. I'll do that one. That's kind of the size I wanted. Can I get trims for the windows? Perfect. I know it's not really a window trim, but it'd look nice. I wish it just place it over. I'm off. I wish it just place it over the top for you. Like there was a snap point for him. Oh, you fuck. Bastard. Yeah, I don't mind that. Just go back to roofs and get this out. The tall one needs to have the shortest one. No, smaller. We do bamboo. I don't think that'll suit it, would it? Well, just a small thatch. The bamboo inside, and we'll put a little, like a little support. We'll find something to support it in a second, and then we'll also have little bamboo things like that. You like columns as well. Enter to, I don't remember what the button, the hotkey is to place it. I'll just keep clicking, I guess. Just pop that in the middle as well. That looks nice, I think. What is this? This is the keeper hut, isn't it? Can we get a nice sign for that? Fit, does it? No, I hate that. I'm not having that. But I've like the we'll go back on the theme and then we'll have the little tapir thing, I suppose. Will they come under theme? Yeah. Maybe just like generic animal ones. I don't like that because you can just see the wall behind it. I don't like that. It's like the idea of having different animals around it. Nice. I think a slightly higher roof on this one. We'll go for 2 meters. A Again, I don't want anything to be that high, so. Might have to go down even more. Yeah. And we want that bamboo base, just because otherwise it looks silly inside. Columns, wasn't it? There we go. Put a little support inside. Just same process on all of them, basically. Just varying the heights of the roof. I think this can be another one. In fact, because the building's lower, I think I'm going to do this as two as well. Might even add a little bit of a thatch to this, the little 1 meter one. Go in that way. We don't really need anything there. Maybe. Just add a little tiny bit there. This one. So 2 meters again, we need the flat roof first. And then pitched roofs. I think if we do that and then get the 1 meter one. Yeah, 1 meter pitched one, yeah. Ah, oh, it's not going to work, actually. It looks silly at the front. We'll do it like that, then. Do one face in the opposite way. I think the main thing with building buildings and decorating on this game is just avoiding like repetition and stuff like that. Like using different colours, different textures, stuff like that. I think that looks fine though for now. Should we add trims? Maybe not. Nah, there's no decent eaves anyway, I don't think. Wait, look. 2 meter eaves. Yeah, we can have it, we might as well. 1 meter, this one, isn't it? I think I'll leave it off, that one. Just doesn't make sense to me having it there. That looks decent enough, I think, for now. Building decorations. I'll build like a whole plant and then decorate. Hey, thanks for the follow, Polsley. I really appreciate it. Maybe leave it at that. Will annoy me if I leave that there. Oh, that one as well. It'd just be raised a little bit. I can get that to stick out, but go just behind the plant. Yeah, there we go, that looks okay. That's probably good overkill. Okay, yeah, that's the only wall that anyone's ever gonna see, so I'm happy just leaving that there. I'm going to unpause it now and just set up the work schedules. Jesus, I spent a lot of money on that. We can get... We need to set up a work zone first. We're going to have them. We'll have them as well. That. That's just going to be, what is it? It's going to be a South America zone, isn't it? There we go. And then we'll have bring up the staff so I can compare everything. Hopefully this will get solved with splitting it up like this. We'll have one of the keepers. Need to get training these again as well. The educator, because there isn't any at the other spots. One mechanic. And one of the vet. And then I'll hire a janitor and a whatchamacallit, security guy, well, for this area. Get both them in there and we'll set a nice perk on the staff room as well. Guests happier. Maybe just rec room, which just have them recovering really fast. It's probably the best one. As long as you can keep them happy with paying them, we're, I don't think we have any issue at the minute with money. But the ongoing expenses was quite high last time. Animal food skyrocketed. Not surprising. Once we get that shop area done as well, that'll be perfect because we'll be making a lot more money off them. All the souvenir shops done. I thought we had someone on the aquatic theme. There we go. I think that'll do for tonight, to be honest. We've made quite a lot of progress there. Got the tapirs all finished up with their heating. We got a brand new dwarf caiman exhibit done. They're absolutely swarming in. These guys are going to be going very soon, I think. I think that's... We're probably better leaving them for now, but... Soon they're going to be gone. Maybe once we get another two exhibits done over here, we're going to get rid of the ostriches and boars until we can build better exhibits for them. But I think next episode we're going to be doing decorating the staff area definitely, getting a food area down definitely, and hopefully getting another habitat done. I don't know which, yeah, I might leave it as a surprise. But we know what six it could be, so... Any of the South American ones, but we'll have a little think about it, and... We'll decide on Tuesday, I guess. So yeah, that's all for today. I'm going to be doing my usual Jackbox stream on Friday, so make sure you come and join in then. Again, thanks for the follow polls, really appreciate it, and I hope you all have a really good night. See you later, guys.